Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at the LEGO Grand Emporium, part of the modular building series. This was released in 2010 and it comes with 2,182 pieces and it's still available today. Let's give this thing a little spin so you can just see a little bit better what it looks like from some different angles. It is a corner unit, as you can see. It fits right at the intersection of two perpendicular streets. And from the non-money shot sides, from the two backs of it, if you will, it doesn't look all that great. Now it's kind of plain back there. They really didn't put much detail there at all. At least you do have a couple windows to let some light inside. And you do have the spots to connect to other modular buildings. They all have the same connection points, but those are intended to be butted up against other buildings, so it's not going to look very good there. And just come back around to the good sides. Let's go ahead and take a look at the details from the outside, starting from the bottom. On this side, you can see the nice dark green awnings and large windows. You can also see the facade that they used with little gaps in it for these kind of column sort of details. This is a little ice cream stand just for a vendor to be standing out there offering up some refreshments on a nice warm day. Coming around to the front, you've got the shop sign, which is a nice brick built element that's just attached to a flexible 3mm tube that bends around the edges. Just use some clip pieces there. You've got tiles used to make a nice little entrance way with a nice design on it there. This is the coolest thing. Possibly the coolest thing in the entire build to me. It's the rotating door set. Got three panes, you can see it rotates very, very nice and neatly. And it also seals up. So when it's right there, you can see it completely closes up the whole thing. That's very nicely done. And then just coming around to the other side, you've got similar awnings again, a street lamp, a little red mailbox, and that actually has an envelope inside of it already. And it opens up from the other side. So you can put things in from here. And then the mailman can come around, open it up from the backside to actually get the stuff out. And you can see you've also got view into the windows here, and there are a couple of mannequins there, which are just minifigures with no faces that are showing off some of the goods. Going up to the second level, you've got some flags around the outside, and then just a bunch of arch and column sort of designs, and gave you a little bit of a bay window sort of design on the side here by just rotating these window, two high window stacks around. So you've got two that are normally attached and then one on the top of this kind of macaroni shaped piece. You can check out the building instructions. Those are available for free online. And the whole thing is done with a 2-brick deep outside. So the outer wall is actually 2 bricks deep at least. So that's how you get the columns coming down here with the windows looking smaller than they actually are, because the windows are actually overlapped behind there. Up to the final level, this one has similar detail going around the whole thing, except under here you've got this overhang, which is just for decorative purposes, a ton of cylinder, 1x1 cylinder pieces, and also these arch pieces that are used to just create that design, just for the sake of design. This is a little stand for a window washer is coming down from above. You'll see that minifigure in the minifigures segment. Again, the kind of bay window sort of detail there. One old style of larger scale flower used for a bit of extra little texture bit there. All this is the same. And then finally, up top, you have this very nice billboard that's showing off that, you know, come here for the shops and be happy, you know, buy some gifts. This is very nicely done, actually. Not a whole lot of pieces used here, some large pieces, except for the sort of mosaic design there, a little bit of 3D. But just the placement of the lights, I think, is very nice. The look of the thing overall just looks like a classic billboard from the times when folks would actually put them up by hand when they weren't pre-printed and folks would actually paint them to a design. And this single support piece back here fits in very nicely. Also on the roof, you've got these huge windows, skylights is what they're working as. And these are actually gigantic windscreen pieces, flat windscreen pieces. Definitely check out the building instructions for this. It's very interesting how they put these in, how they actually place them in. They're actually slid in and held in place by just these little clips, plates with the clips at the end. So there are no studs actually holding that whole thing in. It's very interesting, but lets a lot of light inside. Speaking of the inside, let's start looking at the inside. And to do that, we'll just remove the upper floors, both upper floors. No studs attaching all of this. It's just its own weight holding it in place with a couple little things just to kind of keep the whole thing situated so it's not going to slide off, but otherwise all tiles on the top. So here's a look at the interior. It's kind of Spartan on this first floor. You know, it has a very wide open floor plan. Not a whole lot of stuff in there, so plenty of space to move minifigures around. You can see the backs of the mannequins up here displaying some clothes. You've got some short legs on the wall to represent pants that are up on display. You've got a little perfume counter in the center with some interesting jewelry looking perfume bottles. Some of them are just built up from plates and tiles. This back here is actually an area for changing. It's your changing room area is what that's supposed to be. So they just give you a little bit of privacy with the use of a couple of capes on a flexible 3 millimeter pipe piece, I guess. And you can just flip that up to get under there. And there's a little spot where you can actually sit a minifigure down. Looking around on the other side, you can see on display on the other street corner or the other street side, a hat stand, a couple of hats there. And then you also have the main cash register here, classic style, not a lot of detail on it, but they do have the little drawer, kind of tried to approximate the drawer down at the bottom and the big lever to pull down to actually calculate things. Also a little bit of the glass front display so that patrons can see what's coming up. And you can't see this here, but underneath there are just a few little gems, colored gems, just like this, but without the bottle on display. And that's kind of your jewelry counter. And before we go up to the next level, I just want to show you this back little area. It's kind of the back alley section where I guess, you know, employees go outside to smoke or whatnot. Rubbish container there, glass door, and a simulated lamp up above. And then back on the inside, you've got this mostly brick-built escalator. And that's interesting because the way that it's done, the entire thing is built flat and then you turn it to an angle. So the stairs, the actual steps themselves, are cheese wedge pieces. Those are actually wedges, they're slopes, and because the thing has been sloped up, has been angled up about the same amount as the wedges themselves angle, yeah, it just cancels itself out and they become pretty flat. So very nicely done with the little grill pieces in there to give you it's kind of a simulation of the detail of how those different pieces, you know, come up and down as the escalator gets to the top or to the bottom. And the whole thing is pretty much hinged from down there at the bottom, but just when it gets to the very top, it's finally able to make a connection and they're able to get that actually held in place. Now let's bring in the second floor. Once again, just sits there on tiles, kind of move around just a little bit, but no studs are actually used to attach this. So on the far side there, you can already see that you've got another escalator to help take you up to the third floor, and that's built pretty much, well, exactly the same. I'll just put it that way. This is the housewares floor, so nice little glass, primarily glass banister kind of section, giving you the balcony or the mezzanine effect. And very little really going on up here because that's all that you've got. That's all that you can buy up here. You've got some pans or decorative dishes and some goblets and glasses. That's it. That's really it. I mean, look around the sides, nothing else going on except all of those windows. And here, there you can see how the windows go all the way across, and you can just see the outline of the column detail on the outside on the second layer of the outer wall. But yep, that's it for the second floor. Now for the third floor, set that down right there. And this one to really look at from above because it's getting kind of tall now. This is the toy department. Of course, the toy department is farthest away so that parents get dragged by their kids all the way up to the top floor and they have to stop in between and say, oh, I want that. Oh, I want that. So we've got a scooter here, which a figure can just barely get on. Just a little foot scooter. A couple of balls in different colors. Those are just large action figure series spheres are just put in with some small panel pieces, and you've got what you could call a dollhouse or a birdhouse. I think it's supposed to be a dollhouse though. Just a very small little number of pieces used to create what's essentially a micro or sub-micro build. Very nicely done for what they're trying to pull off there, and it's nice that you can actually rotate this around on that 2x2 jumper piece. But again, that's all you have for products up here. But if you rotate this around over to here on the other side over that open center section, they have a very nice kind of chandelier sort of detail up there. Kind of going to be kind of hard to just squeeze the camera in, but there it is. Lots of clear pieces used there. Sorry for the jiggliness of it right now. I'm holding the camera by hand, but that's a very nice looking thing. Lots of simulated glass used for it, and it would especially look good from underneath. So this is something that the minifigures would really be able to appreciate even more than we can. But when it was out during the building phase, it was something that looked especially nice. And now that's it, because all that's left is the roof. So let's go ahead and take a look at the minifigures at least. All these figures use the same face, and they use common and commonly reused print pieces, so you can change around their roles as you wish. But I think what was intended here was that this is the store employee or clerk who would be working at the register. This is a male patron, customer coming in, trying out different clothes, aka Lego Movie's Where Are My Pants guy, I believe the inspiration for him. And this is a patron who has just left the store with a couple of shopping bags. This is a kid who's coming in, who's probably going to be going straight or trying to go straight to the third floor to look at the toys. And this is that window washer guy who would normally be perched on the little jig outside, just holding him, sort of crane style thing. And he uses his broom like this, just sticks it out like that, and it's able to fit right into the window sections. Let's take a look at these from the back so you can see the remainders of their prints. Obviously the kid has a pirates theme top to him, and that's it for those. And here are the mannequins from the first floor. Just wanted to show those so you can see exactly what they're wearing. Very interesting, always the difference in height between the male and female when you use the full height slope piece, the 2-brick high slope piece, to create the dress here. Just a fantasy era costume used there. And looking at these from the back, there you can see that. I'll just take off this hair so you can see the remainder. There is a face! What? There is a face! Yes! So technically you could use both of these as minifigures. Just set them up like this and walk them right into the store. So I think this building looks great from the outside. Makes a very solid statement, has charming little minifigures, has some very nice little design elements, and some nice details on the inside. It just doesn't have many details on the inside. So that's really where it's lacking. Just the earlier point in the development of Creator into the whole minifig scale world before they started adding more stuff on the inside. But other than that, it's still a classic set, you know, and it was an instant classic when it was released, and it's still much loved today, and rightfully so. So that's it for my look at this set. Be sure to share your opinions, your thoughts about this set in the comment section below. Stay tuned for more reviews to come from me, new stuff, old stuff, as well as custom builds that I do, and you can follow all the updates of everything Lego related in my life at JANGBRiCKS.com. Talk to you again soon.